Hey everybody, I'm here today to once again have the audacity to ask the question, is Lego a good value? And this is once again going to be controversial because this is another one of those days when I've decided to compare a Lego thing to a real thing. And I have here the Lego Atari 2600 and an actual Atari 2600, or more specifically the VCS system, the video computer system, just a version of what we typically refer to as the 2600. And this one is real, and it actually works, and it actually plays games. I just had it hooked up recently, and I'll be showing you some footage of it actually playing games on a modern TV and everything. This is controversial because the Lego one cost $240. This over here cost $50. There are other options as well that I'll mention, other ways that you can get into an actual console that will play games. But I wanted to focus on these two primarily because one of the main selling points of this Lego one here is that it looks like the old console. For folks who are nostalgic for the old console, for folks who want to feel that feeling of back in the day, you know, back in the day when things were better, when things were really, really good. And they've captured all of that so well. The nostalgia hit is there. It is very, very extremely successful. Definitely check out my full review of the Lego version over on my Lego Reviews channel if you're interested in my thoughts about that. You must see it from all angles and everything. I've got that covered, and Lego has us covered with all of the nostalgia here, which is great. But for folks who are looking for that nostalgia hit, why not? Why not get the real thing? Especially when you can pick this up for like $50 US. $50 US! 75 clean with multiple controllers and a bunch of games. Honestly, I feel like the Lego offering over here is pretty standard value-wise by today's heavily inflated standards for the amount of stuff that you get here. I really don't feel like this is a ripoff for the amount of stuff that you get here. This does have extra stuff to it. Interior detail, the cartridges are excellent. The building experience itself is excellent. These extra things are things, but most importantly, the build experience is something that you do once and then it's done. Now, I personally really, really enjoyed this, but most critically, the build experience here for a typical Lego fan who, you know, knows what they're doing and is familiar with parts and the way that Lego does their instructions will take 5 to 6 hours to put this together. And it's a very nice experience. And then you're done. And then there's nothing else that you're going to do with this afterwards. You're just going to have it on display. It's going to collect dust. It's going to be a collector's item. It's going to bring you joy because it's simply there. Yes, you will remember the build experience, and that has some value. But I personally didn't feel like the build for this was mind-blowing. It didn't leave a residual warmth in my heart. It wasn't one of the more standout build experiences that I've ever been through, or even in recent times. Quality here is very good, but primarily this is going to be used by almost everybody as just a gee whiz thing on a shelf. Like, look at that. It has the extra gee whizness compared to the real deal of being a Lego thing that is full scale and looks like the real deal, so that if somebody is visiting you and they've never seen it before, you can be like, look, I've got this retro thing. Look at the Atari, look at my old Atari. And they can look at it and be like, oh, wow, that's cool. It's so clean. It's in really, really good condition and everything. And then you can be like, look even closer. That's made of Lego. Whoa. Okay. There's all of your value for this. After it's built, there's all of your value right there. You can look at it. You can enjoy it. Enjoy seeing it. And people who don't know what it is can be surprised for a moment that it's made of Lego because it looks like the real thing. Compare that to this, which is the real thing, which gives you that display value. And it also has the very real value of being the real deal, the actual retro thing. You know, for folks who want to have a connection to the old school, to the old days, this is actually it. It's not a replica. This is from sometime between 1980 and 1982. And also, you can take it down from that shelf and you can plug it in with a $5 adapter from Amazon. You can plug it in to a modern TV and then you can play a game with it. And then you can have a stack of games. You can play all of those games. Now, there's one other option as well for folks who want more lasting experience, more lasting value, more varied experiences for their money. And that is, well, it's not one option, actually. It's the whole world of emulators out there and modern retro consoles. There are a number of companies that have made options for you. And for easily under $100, you can get a brand new inbox today, or let's say about $50 used. You can get a perfectly good working small emulated system that will play like 100 games that are built in, maybe more, you know, roughly about 100 games forever. Even easier to connect to modern TVs and everything. So if you want more play value, you can get that as well for a similar price range over here on the real world side for less than half the price, less than half the price of the Lego one. I think it's valuable to have that conversation, to consider that, to be willing to look outside of the brick-based construction toy world when trying to figure out what Lego actually competes against and what else can you do with your dollar. How much value can you actually get for what you want from Lego? Again, I am a major, major fan of Lego. This goes without saying. I have dedicated a lot of years to the Lego hobby. I am not a Lego hater. I'm just a realist. And realistically, this is not competing against any static models. This is not competing against any other brick-based construction system or company out there that makes brick-based stuff, Lego-compatible stuff, or even Lego-incompatible constructibles, right? There's no other form of craft that this competes against. This is simply going for that retro hit with a little bit of building experience as well. This gives you all of the retro hit and so much more. So in my mind, in this case here, Lego has done a fantastic job. I don't think they could have done much better. Certainly for the console, joystick, and the cartridge system that they came up with. I don't think they could have done any better than that. They're already almost a perfect one-to-one scale representation. It's tight, it's clean. Gaps are small, tons of prints in here. This is really, really good stuff for Lego. But for me, if I am going to make a recommendation to somebody out there who's not sure if they want to spend $240 of their hard-earned money, because that's not a small amount, except for rich people. If you're rich, get whatever you want. You don't have to think about value of anything. But if you're not filthy, stinking rich, like the most of us aren't, then it's worthwhile to consider, in my opinion. Even if you're a super Lego fan, what else can you do? What else can you do with your money? And is Lego a good value for you? I hope this was an interesting thought experiment for you, at least, even if you completely disagree that this is the better value and the better thing for nostalgia here. But thank you for watching. Again, my review of this is up on my Lego Reviews channel, which has been going strong for over a year now. Link in the video description and from my main channel page, etc. That's where all of my new Lego reviews go. And to see me build things like this live, as well as some non-Lego things from time to time, be sure to follow me on Twitch. It's twitch.tv/itsthejang. Once again, link in the video description. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.